I'm really loving this spot. Haven't really found a good flat spot to put my tarp yet, but I'm just feeling a vibe. And I know I can work with it. Tomorrow morning, hopefully before sunrise, I'm going to climb this hill. Hopefully see sunrise from the top of the hill. I know it's going to be a great view.
Woke up around 6:30 this morning. It's around 7 right now. I have my food and drink to go. And I'm gonna try to make it up this hill right here before the sun rises, just to get a good glimpse. Thank you.
I think invigorating would be the word. Something inherently about getting up high that makes you feel alive. Try to make it over there. Probably take me about half an hour or so, maybe less, 20 minutes. Looks steep. Looks like it should have a great view. I swear this bird is riffing on a Latin American rhythm right now. He's that guy in the shaker. Hiking these off-trail routes, you always got to be really careful about loose rocks. And the loose rocks can be bigger than you think, just like this one. You grab onto that or you step on that not carefully, it could ruin your day. I love all these amazing chatter marks on the top of these ridges here. Now what are chatter marks, you might be asking? Chatter marks are not the marks on somebody's face after they get beat up for talking too much. Though I'm sure you could call them that as well. Chatter marks are from the glacier that used to be on top of here, which was 2 to 3 kilometers thick at some points. And moving from north to south, and this way is north, and you can imagine rocks and all debris kind of stuck at the bottom of it, and they're pushing along the bottom of the glacier like this, but they get stuck, and then but the pressure kind of builds up and it bumps and kind of goes like this over time and takes chunks out of the rocks. So that's how geologists can tell which way the glaciation came from. I mean, you don't have to be a geologist to see it. Once you kind of know the pattern and how it works, it's pretty easy. finally turning around. I'm gonna take my sweet time though. So much to take in. So I'm gonna go back down to the lake and have some lunch, but those are the two hills off in the distance that I might climb if I can. And there's my campsite, way down there. Well, it seems like I'm not the only one living under my tarp. This weather is amazing. It's just a few days before November and I could get a tan. I almost feel like going for a swim. The last hurrah of summer. Probably starting the day after tomorrow when some weather is going to move in. It won't be like this till spring. I've decided I'm gonna head back uphill over here, go to a new spot, explore some new areas. I'm gonna try to hit up that ridgeline over there, and then there's a bigger hill behind it. The forest is far less chaotic than it appears. All maples over here. softwoods, cedars and pines. It's really interesting to consider that this large stone has been resting on this small stone for approximately 20,000 years, at least. I wonder how many more thousand years this large stone will be sitting atop the small one. We're now on top of that cliff I was pointing to earlier, and that's the campsite down there. Isn't happiness, I don't know what is. I heard somebody say that, I forget who it was, but it's one of the most profound things I've ever heard. It's funny how the happiest moments of my life, I never recognized it at the time, not until afterwards, and I had time to process, did I realize what a profound experience that was. We often had these misconceptions that happiness is this feeling that is a full saturation of joy filled to the brim. But more often than not, it's not like that. Often have other things going on in our mind and other things we're processing at the moment. But I don't know any other way to sort of bring it back to the moment and saying, if this isn't happiness, I don't know what is. It's a truly magnificent morning. I have a light tailwind, which suits my mood well. I'm feeling a little slow after all that hiking yesterday, but it's a slow contentment, if anything. Feeling in a rather contemplative mood. Looking forward to winter, but I really appreciate this last gasp of summer.